Welcome to Melita's Delicacies. Friends, thank you for all your love and support. And thank you for all the likes and shares for my previous videos. If you are new to my channel, please do like, share, and don't forget to subscribe to Melita's Delicacies for more interesting recipes coming every week. And today I'm back again with one more interesting recipe, and that is the pumpkin pudding. For this, we need a fully ripe pumpkin. You can see that this is my completely ripe pumpkin. I'm going to just cut it and remove one piece of the pumpkin. Now, here I have taken one slice of this ripe pumpkin. Just scrape off the seeds and the top part of it. The seeds you can dry up and later on peel and just eat them or incorporate in some dish of yours. Cut it into pieces and peel off. Mind you, this pumpkin is a little difficult to peel and as the skin is really very hard. If you take this type of pumpkin, it is sweeter also and the pudding comes out really nice. The texture of the pudding comes really good. So peel the pumpkin and slice it. Don't make very thick slices because it will take a longer time to get them steamed. Now the cut slices, you just steam them. Now I have a steamer already kept on boil, so I'm putting out on them. And friends, thank you so very much for all the love that you have shown to me throughout this journey, and especially the last two recipes of the Christmas cake fruit soaking video and the bottle gourd dose. By the time the pumpkin gets steamed, let's make the caramel for the pudding. I have taken here a pan, preferably a non-stick pan, and I've added 2 tablespoons of sugar, and it is on high flame. Do not use any spoon or anything to stir it, just swirl a little bit, otherwise the sugar can crystallize. So to avoid that, do not stir it, just swirl the pan. The sugar has started to melt. Swirl it so that all the sugar gets melted well. It started bubbling. Handle the trickle very carefully because it has high temperature. If it comes in contact with your skin, you can get burnt marks. This time, keep the gas on full flame. Now as it slowly starts becoming golden and starts fuming, add 1 tablespoon of warm water and swirl it, and as it thickens up again, quickly transfer into the mold in which you want to steam your pudding. Just swirl it around so that the whole bottom part of your mold gets coated with it. Before you pour in your trickle in the mold, make sure that your mold is completely dry. I have explained how to make trickle in my previous banana pudding recipe. Please, I'm giving a link in the description. Do watch it as well. Now here my pumpkin slices are steamed for 10 minutes. I'll remove them off and let them cool. Just slightly mesh them so that it becomes easy to measure the quantity of the pumpkin. Now it is about pressed 1 full cup and 1 tablespoon, like less than a tablespoon in fact. Just put it in your blender. If you have a hand blender, that can be done in that also, but I am trying to make my work a little simpler. Mind you, this is completely cooled now. Add about 1 tablespoon of rum. This is optional. You can use any other flavoring like vanilla essence. I have used rum because it gives a very festive taste to the pudding. Now here I have taken about 200 ml of milk, of which half I am adding in my jar now. Here is half cup of sugar. Now sugar will depend upon your preference of sweetness and also how sweet is your pumpkin. Now add about 1 tablespoon of butter to give that creamy texture, and I'm using 100 ml of fresh cream. This is because my milk was skimmed milk. If you're using full fat milk, there is no need to add the cream. Straight away you can add 300 ml of milk. Add a pinch of salt to enhance the sweetness, and add 4 fresh room temperature eggs to your jar and blend them to a fine puree. If your blender jar is large one, you can put all these together and blend it at one go. Since my jar is small, I have to do it, you know, in batches. Here it is, all the mixture is done of the pumpkin, eggs and everything. Now since my jar was small, my milk was left behind, that I'll just swirl in the mixer jar and incorporate it now and give it a quick mix before I add this to the mold. If your jar is large and you can incorporate everything together and blend it, then there is no need of mixing this and additional washing another bowl. I'm passing this to a colander so that the pudding has a smooth texture. I've already kept my water to boil to steam this, or you can steam it in the, give it a water bath in your oven, but I am trying to, you know, as easy as possible. Grate a little of nutmeg for that extra flavor and slowly mix it with a spoon just on the top. Make sure you do not touch the spoon at the bottom, because otherwise your trickle will get scraped off. Cover it with a lid or cover with a silver foil, whatever you prefer. Now in this water, just keep a stand, keep this on it, don't keep directly into the water. Close it and steam it for about 45 to 50 minutes, depending upon your guess and the size and, you know, the quantity, all that will differ. So add water accordingly in your vessel so that it lasts for about 45 to 50 minutes. Just turn off, let the flame come down, wait for about 2-3 minutes so that the juices settle down, and then do the toothpick or the skewer test, passing through. If it comes clean, then it is done. But you do the skewer test when it's still boiling, sometimes the skewer doesn't come out clean. So keep that also in mind. And once it is completely cooled, refrigerate it for minimum of 4 to 6 hours, or preferably overnight. You can have it warm also, but chilled one tastes better. And before turning it, just warm it up a little bit at the bottom so that the comes out very clean. Hold your breath, because turning pudding always gives me anxiety. Oh, what a beautiful glaze that it has got, the perfect pumpkin pudding color to it. See the texture also of it. Can't wait to do the taste test. The perfect cut, wow. The perfect texture, you can see that a pumpkin pudding can have. Friends, when you try this recipe at home, please take care of the measurements. If your liquid is more, the milk that you use, then, or if you boil the pumpkin in water, then the texture can change a little bit. But here, since I've steamed it, there is no addition of any water to it. And you can see it's so delicious, friends. I can't tell you. My mouth is just watering right now. Do try this recipe at your home. So delicious and just melt in the mouth. Every slice, you can see the texture is so perfect. It is much better than your bread pudding, which you add so much of bread, you know. This is a perfect delicacy. And keep watching Melita's Delicacies for more such interesting recipes coming up every week from my kitchen to you with all love. And thank you for all your love and support. God bless you.